Hello students, hope you all are fine.
Good.
Today we will continue our second chapter, that is basic concepts of economics. So first we will discuss about price. So what is a price? The price of a commodity is that the amount of money that one must pay to get this commodity. For example, when we say that the price of a shirt is rupees 1000, it means that we have to pay rupees 1000 to get this shirt. So, what is equilibrium price? Yes, it is the price at which quantity demanded equals quantity supplied. Competition among the buyers and the sellers ensures that the price is ultimately settled at the equilibrium level. Now, tell me about market. Yes, it is a system or arrangement by which buyers and sellers of a commodity are able to interact and communicate with each other to determine the price and the quantity to be bought and sold. So there are two types of market. First one is product market. Product market or goods market are those market where consumer goods and services are bought and sold. Second type is factor market, and it are those markets where factor services are bought and sold. So, for example, cloth market and car market are examples for only the goods market, but whereas in the labor market, firms are the buyers and households are the sellers of labor service. These all come in a factor market. Now, let's learn about money. Money is an exchange medium where goods and services are exchanged directly from the other goods and services. But in earlier, there was a barter system. Barter system knows to the system of exchange where goods and services are exchanged directly for the other goods and services. So, money is defined as anything that is generally and widely accepted as a means of exchange and at the same time acts as a measure and a store of value. So, there are some components of money. First one is currency. Currency consists of currency notes and coins. For example, currency notes are rupees 5, 10, 20 and 2000. But the coins are metallic and it is also known as currency. For example, 50 paise, 1, 2, 5 paise and 10 paise also. Now, second one is deposit money or bank money. Deposit money refers to the deposits held at the banks on the basis of which checks could be drawn. There are some functions of money which it performs. First one is medium of exchange. Money is generally and widely accepted as the medium through which purchases or sales are made. Second one is measure of value or unit account. Money also serves as a unit of account. When we express the value of a commodity in terms of money, it is known as price. All prices are quoted in terms of money. For example, the price of a textbook is quoted as rupees 300. Now, standard of deferred payment. Money serves as a standard of deferred payment. This simply means that a payment to be made in future can be stated in money terms. Now, the last point is store of value. Money also serves as a store of value, that is, people can keep their wealth in the form of money. Money allows us to store purchasing power which can be used by any time in future to purchase goods and services. Now, we will study about income, national income and per capita income. So first, what is income? Income is the flow of goods and services over time. In modern economics, income is expressed in monetary terms such as individual earning an income of ₹50,000 per month. Some people earn income by selling commodities they have produced by their own labor. Now, second one is national income. National income is defined as the value of all final goods and services produced by the normal residents of a country in a year. Now, next one is per capita income. Per capita income is the average income of the normal residents of our country in a particular year. It is income per head of population. It is obtained by dividing national income of a country by its population. Now, tell me, what is savings? It is a part of the income which is not used as consumption expenditure. It comprises personal saving, business saving, and government saving. Now, what is investment? The act of using productive resources for the production of capital goods. It comprises producers' fixed investment, investment in structures, and inventory investments. So, producers' fixed investment consists of tools, machinery, equipments, and plants. Investment in residential and non-residential structure includes investment made in the construction of residential houses and non-residential structure such as office, power plants, bridges, roads, etc. And inventory investment are those investments which keep stock of raw material, semi-finished goods and finished goods in factories or shops for smooth production. Now, our last topic is wealth. So, wealth refers to a stock of all those assets which are a source of income. We may speak of individual wealth as well as national wealth. Individual or personal wealth refers to a stock of all those assets which are owed by a person. And the wealth of an entire nation is called national wealth. It is the total wealth of all the residents of a country. National wealth is the stock of all the tangible assets that contribute to the production of goods and services. So it comprises reproducible assets and non-reproducible assets. Reproducible assets are man-made and therefore can be reproduced. And non-reproducible assets consist of natural resources such as the land, mineral, wealth, and forests, etc. So students, after seeing this video, go through the chapter, underline the important points and learn it. So thank you and take care.